Okay, so this is a continuation and this is the last part. Okay, so multiple weight problem, multiple weights problem in a ship that is initially listed. And our previous lesson, that is multiple weights problem in a ship that is initially upright. No? So dito naman, it is initially listed. Okay, so the center of gravity of the ship, that is capital G, is off the center line when the ship is listed. So it is off the center line when the ship is listed. And if you remember, I told you the last time that if there is no list, there is no G to G sub H. No? So this is the list triangle, that is the angle of list is at the meta center. And this line is actually the vertical line of action of the buoyancy force. Kasi yun ang dumadaan sa meta center, no? Yung iyong weight force is acting through G. Ngayon, pag lumipat yung G mo dito, dito na siya nag-act, no? Okay. So this will be your G to G sub H. Alam niyo na to, no? Paulit-ulit niyo. And this will be your GM. Okay, so we already have this formula. I have already explained this. Tangent theta is equal to G to G sub H divided by GM. No? And of course, dito, there will always be a GM that is already given. No? And, or if it is not given, we can calculate. No? And also, there is a list. Kasi nga, this is a weight problem in a ship that is initially listed. So there is already a list. So meron na tayong theta, no? So what we need to calculate is the G to G sub H. That is, we need to transpose this. Tangent over 1. Because any number that is divided by or multiplied by 1 is equal to that number. So okay lang yan, no? So that we can cross multiply for transposition. Okay, so 1 times G to G sub H is equal to GM times tangent theta, which is hindi na kailangan yung 1 times. Hindi natin kailangan yan, ano? Because it will give you the same result. Okay, so G to G sub H here is the listing lever. That will be the distance to be multiplied by the initial displacement when taking the moments about the center line in the listing moments table. If you remember that in our previous meeting, no, we worked on two tables. That is the KG table. Ganun din dito, no? KG moments table and also the listing moments table. So we will work also here, no? So here, it is already specified that your, kaya natin kinuha kagad ng maaga yung G to G sub H because we have an angle of list, no? And this G to G sub H is the listing lever that will be the distance to be multiplied by the initial displacement when taking the moments about the center line. So alam nyo na yon yung taking the moments about the center line. And of course, moments is equal to weight times distance. And the distance here is your G to G sub H, which is your listing lever, no? While the weight here is your displacement. Diba? Okay, so let's go to the example. Example na kagad tayo. There is no need to tell you the steps. Alam na natin dahil it is almost the same. Kaya lang nauna lang dito. Nauna yung taking of the GM, no? Okay, so topic 10, example number 8. No? A ship with a displacement of 16,000 tons and kg of 8.5 meters, km of 9.7 meters, and listing to port side by 4 degrees, will work on the following cargoes. Okay, so first is to load 175 tons at kg 7.9 meters, 6.1 meters starboard side of the center line. So kailangan natin mag-drawing ng ship that is listed to port. Konti lang. Okay, maganda-ganda yung aking kamay ngayon. Pero gagamitin natin ang ruler sa center line of the vessel. Yun. Di ba tabi kayo? Okay, so that is the center line of the vessel, no? Okay, so we will work on these cargoes, 175 tons at kg of 7.9 meters, 6.1 meters starboard side. So dito, no? So this is already initially listed. And that is 6.17, no, tansyahin lang natin, it is somewhere here, no? Okay, so this is actually, okay, this is 6.1 meters starboard side. And this is a kg of, this is your g, this is your k, that is kg of, syempre, dito ko na lang isulat sa baba, 7.9. Okay. And then the next cargo will be 310 tons, mas mabigat. KG of 7, so mas mababa lang siya ng konti, but on the center line. So wala siyang effect dun sa listing moment. No? Meron konti, pero negligible. No? Okay, so mas mababa siya ng konti, let's say dito. Okay. So that is 0. Ang iyong distance of the center line is 0. Siyempre, di ba? And this is your G. This is your K. So meron tayong KG of 7.0 meters. And then we will work again 100 tons. KG 7.0, 5.2 meters port side of the center line. Okay. So the same dito katapat niya, no? Katapat. Pero 5.2 meters lang. So somewhere here. Okay, the same kg, that is 7.0, and then this is only 5.2 meters. Okay, siyempre pagka meron tayong meron kayong isosolve, there is no need to draw like this, no? Kaya ako lang dinadrawing para maintindihan nyo kung saan yung kinakarga natin, ano? There is no need, I need only the solution yung gagawin, no? Okay, what is required? That is to calculate the final list if the KM will remain constant, which is yung KM natin is 9.7. Okay, solution is to calculate the initial GM. Okay, so calculate the initial GM, that is, ano bang initial GM, ano bang KM natin, that is 9.7 meters. Ano yung initial KG natin, that is 8.5 meters. So minus mo lang yan, that is 9.7 minus 8.5 is 1.2 meters. And then we will use the formula. Tangent theta is equal to g to g sub h over gm, which is transpose. Cross multiply, 1 times g to g sub h, ito na siya. Gm times tangent theta, ito na siya. No? Okay, so that is gm is 1.2 times tangent 4 degrees. Okay, so let us try in our calculator. Okay, so that is our GM is 1.2 times 4 degrees tangent. Tangent equals Yan, no? 0.0839. Okay, so hindi ko na sinama yung 1. Eh. Negligible na yung effect nun. Ano? So, okay, so meron tayong G2G subpage. Let's go to the next slide. Okay, so the next is, of course, to make the to work on the KG table, no? So ito kasi ay Excel. So let's go to the ano, to the PowerPoint. Okay, the next step is to determine the final KG, which is using the KG moments table, no? Okay, initial displacement natin is 16,000, no? And initial KG is 8.5 meters. And then we are going to load 100. Okay, puro load naman ito. So there is no negative, no? So load natin is 175, 310, and 100 respectively. And the KG is 7.9, 7.0, and 7.0. So as usual, moment will be weight times distance. Distance about the keel. It means your reference point in measuring the distance is the keel. Kaya KG ang ating gagamitin, no? So that is equal to 136,000, 1,382.5, 2170, and also 700, no? Okay, the total will be, total moments will be 140,252.5, and the total weight here is, of course, nagdagdag na because these are all loaded to the vessel. So ibig sabihin, lumaki na yung displacement. So this can be your final displacement or total weights. Okay, so pareho lang yan. Baka in other books kasi makita niyo yung final displacement, baka malito kayo. So that is the same, no? Also this one, final moments or total moments, those are the same, no? Okay, so paano natin nakuha ito? Paano natin nakuha yan? Sino nakakaalala, paano natin nakuha yan?
Divide po.
Di-divide po yung moment sa weight, total weight.
Okay, so that's correct. Okay. Which is, meron tayong formula. Sabi ko nga, pagtanda mo itong formula na to hanggang licensure exam na yan, no? Which is the final KG is equal total or final moments. Divided by total weight or final displacement. Yeah, wala, hindi kayo malito, ano? Or, lalagyan ko dito ng ano, ano? Total weights. Okay, that is 140,252. By the way, yung be careful with using the comma, ano? Because if you are in other countries, yung comma nila is yung period natin, ano? So, baka magtaka ka, bakit period ang ginamit? Yung period, yun ang comma, baliktad sila, ano? Okay, so that is 140,252.5 tons meter. Andun, sa taas, yeah, tons meter. Divided by 16,585 tons. Okay, so tons and tons, that is canceled. So the unit will be meters. Okay, so 140,252.5 divided by 16,585 is equal to 8.45658. Okay, so it's up to you to use how many decimal places, no? 8.4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 5, 9. Yeah. That is meters. Okay, and then we must obtain the final GM, that is KM minus final KG. So ang KM natin is 9.7, hindi nagbago according to the problem, minus your final KG. That is equal to 1.243. No? Okay, next. Okay, ito na yung tinatawag nating listing. Okay, let me change the color. Tawag natin dito is listing moments table. Okay, dito yung natin lalagay yung weight, that is the weight of the vessel. And then yung load natin, 175, 310, and 100 tons respectively. And the distance of the center line, okay, if you remember, nakalagay dun sa instructions sa una, that is, this is your G to G sub H, di ba? So dyan natin i-multiply yan to obtain the moment, which is port side moment. Bakit port side? Kasi nakalagay dun sa problem that you are listing to o port. Di ba? Kaya sa port side natin nilalagay. Pag nakalagay dun na listing to starboard, dun sa starboard mo ilalagay. No? And then we have 175 tons, that is 6.1 starboard side. So dun mo ilalagay. No? Multiply it and then equals. And then 310 on the center line, on the center line, kaya zero. So 310 times zero is zero. There is no effect, no? And then 100 tons times 5.2 port side. Okay, so dito natin lalagay naman sa port side, which is 520 tons moments, na? Okay, so tignan na, kunin natin yung total, which is 1,862.4. And the other side, starboard ay 1,067. Okay, paano natin i-subtract yan? Tanggalin ko muna isinulat ko dito. No? Para hindi magulo. Okay, para I will change the color para ma-distinguish natin. Okay. So, susubtract natin. Di ba sabi ko nung in the previous meeting, sabi ko if we're going to subtract, that is starboard side muna. Starboard, that is 1067.5. And then, next is yung port ng ating ima-minus, that is minus 1,862.4. Yeah. So okay, so gumitan natin calculator at mahina ako sa arithmetic. Wala. Okay, so 1067.5 minus 1862.4 is equal to, yan, negative 794.9. Okay, so pwede mo naman, baligtarin yan. Gusto ba mauna yung 1,008, mauna yung port bago yung starboard. Okay lang yun, ano? Basta tandaan mo lang na yung port side will be the greater value, no? The greater moment. Kung ano bang mas mataas, port side moments or starboard side moments. So mas mataas to, no? Kaya mas mataas to, that is port side, no? yung ating answer mamaya. Pero dito kasi sa negative, yan, nasanay na ako. Pag negative, that is, of course, fourth side, no? Okay, so, we will get the final G to G sub H. So, actually, this is final, no? Although, hindi naman nilagay na final sa book. So, I don't like to put it also as final. So, this is your G to G sub H. This is all. It is better we call this new, no? Not final. Although, pareho lang naman yan, final. Okay. Kasi magbabago na yung G to G sub H mo, no? Kasi nag-load tayo, no? So, this will be your new G to G sub H. That is equal to the total listing moments divided by the total weights, which is negative 794.9 divided by, okay, so dito gagamitin natin yung, remember, gagamitin natin yung total weight, which is, wala naman tayong discard, so walang negative, no? Kaya walang problema. Pero just in case na may na-discharge yan, then add it algebraically. Or, pick upin mo yung cage sa cage table, no? If we go back here, pick upin mo lang yan, di ba? Pick upin mo lang to. Okay. Which is, nandun na siya, no? And then, we will try to solve. Okay, meron na dyan, no? Divided by 16,585 is equal to, yan, no? 0.04793. Yan ang aking ginamit para hindi alanganin, no? Hindi alanganin yung, baka mamaya may malaking effect. Okay, then we will use again the tangent theta, which is tangent angle of least, because we are now looking for the new angle of least or the final angle of least, no? This is the final angle of least, which is tangent theta is equal to G to G sub H divided by final GM. No? And that is negative 0.04793 divided by 1.243, that is, okay, so tignan natin. Okay, ganyan na lang gamitin natin para kompleto. Divided by 1.243 equals, and that is inverse tangent or second function, that is arc tangent na, no? Oh, nakita nyo, this is negative 2.2 degrees. And that is fourth side. Bakit fourth side? Kasi negative, no? That is negative. Oh, ibang kulay. Wait. Okay. Diba negative? So yung negative dito, there is no need to Right that one. Pero kahit isulat nyo, okay lang sa akin yan. No? Okay, so this is now the new angle of least. New. Nagbago na siya, no? Okay, any question? Any question regarding that?